I saw, this is a song that I yelled out at a Dylan concert, and he actually did it. I think he heard me. I like to think he heard me.
Shut the kid up!
He wasn't planning on it. John Brown went off to war to fight on a foreign shore. His mama sure was proud of him. He stood so straight and tall in his uniform and all. His mama's face broke out into a grin. Oh son, you look so fine, I'm glad you're a son of mine. It makes me proud to know you wear a gun. Do what the captain says, a lot of medals you will get. We'll put them on the wall when you get home. That train pulled out. John's mom began to shout, telling everybody in the neighborhood, that's my son who's about to go. He's a soldier now, you know. She made damn well sure they understood. She got a letter every once in a while. Her face broke into a smile. She showed them to the people from next door. She bragged about her son with his uniform and gun and this thing she called a good old-fashioned war. Then the letter ceased to come. For a long time they did not come. They ceased to come for about 10 months or more. Then the letter finally came, saying go down and meet the train. Your son is coming back from the war. Well, she smiled and went right down. She looked up and all around. She did not see her soldier son in sight. But as the people passed, she saw her son at last. When she did, she could not believe her eyes. His hands were all shot up. His face was blown away. He wore a metal brace around his waist. He whispered kind of slow in a voice she didn't know. She couldn't even recognize his face. Pray tell me, darling son, tell me what they've done. Tell me how you've come to be this way. He tried his best to talk, but his mouth could barely move. His mother had to turn her face away. Don't you remember, Ma, when I went off to war? You thought it was the best thing I could do. I was on the battleground, you were home acting proud. You weren't there standing in my shoes. I was over there thinking, what am I doing here? I'm trying to kill somebody or die trying. Oh, but what scared me most when my enemy came close, I could see that his face looked just like mine. Through the thunder and the stink, I couldn't help but think that I was just a puppet in a play. Through the fire and the smoke, the string finally broke and a cannonball blew my eyes away. As he turned away to walk, his mother still in shock to see the metal brace that helped him stand. But before she turned to go, he called his mother close and he dropped his medals down into her hand. And he dropped his medals down into her hand.